Dear friend, welcome to the lecture series in microprocessors and microcontrollers. In today's video lecture, we are going to learn about the concept of physical memory organization of 8086 microprocessor. We know that the 8086 microprocessor has 20-bit address lines. So there are 20 address lines that are available. So from these 20 address lines, by taking 2 power 20, we can access this much of memory. So this entire number will give us the 1 MB memory. So there will be 1 MB memory that can be accessible by the 20 address lines. Hence, the 8086 memory address space can be viewed as a sequence of 1 MB that we can see in this figure. So we will be having the 1 MB memory. So the entire 1 MB memory will be looking like a sequence of the memory locations. So here, this entire 1 MB can be divided into segments. So 1 MB divided by 16 logical segments, so that we can get each segment size that will be of 64 KB. So if you look at the segment one, the segment one will be having the capacity of 64 KB, and segment two, that also will be having the 64 KB. So like that, the sequence of segments will be available in the 1 MB memory. So here we can also see each segment will be having the starting address as well as the ending address. So the segment one, if you look at here, the segment one, the starting address will be of 000, then 00, and whatever the addresses that we are representing here will be in hexadecimal. Now the end address of this particular segment will be 0FFF. So like this, the second segment will start after the location, which is the end address of the segment one. So the segment two starts at 10000H, then again it will be ending at 1FFFFH. So like that, each and every segment is having the starting address as well as the ending address. So whatever the addresses that we have represented here, everything will be hexadecimal representation only. Each memory location contains 8-bit data or 1 byte of data. So if we look at the sequence of the memory, so here that we can see, so the first location will be of 00, 00, then 0. Now the second location will be 00001, and the third location will be 00002. Like that, it keeps going and it ends at the end address FFFF and F, right? So in each and every location, we can store up to a byte data. So as we know, the byte is equivalent to 8 bits. So we can store 8 bit of data or 1 byte of data within a one memory location. Now, if we look at the memory location address of 8086, it contains 20-bit address. That 20-bit address can be written as, you know, 5-digit hexadecimal equivalent code. So here each digit represents 4 bits. So here there are 5 digits are available. So there will be accumulating to 20 bits. Any two consecutive memory locations contain 16-bit data or a word. So here we know each location will store 1 byte data. And if you want to store 16-bit data, then two consecutive locations can be used to store that 16-bit data. And here we are calling that 16-bit data as a word. So if we take 2 bytes as a word, there will be of around 524287 number of bytes that can be available. And if we look at in bytes, it will be 104857 number of bytes that we can store within the 1 MB memory of the 8086 physical memory. Physically, the memory can be organized as two banks, and those two banks are known as even and odd bank. So here we will be having the 1 MB memory. So this 1 MB memory will be divided into two memory banks. One is even and one is odd memory bank. So here it will be the even memory bank, and here it will be called as the odd memory bank. So each bank size will be 512 KB. So whatever the 1 MB that is available, that 1 MB will be divided equal into two. So each part will get 512 KB of memory. Now we are calling this particular 512 KB as even memory bank. So if we look at the address locations of that particular 512 KB memory, will be having the even number of addresses. It is going to contain the even number of locations. So that's why it is called as the even memory bank. And in case of the odd memory bank, the addresses that are used are odd numbered locations, right? So because of this, we are calling that one as odd memory bank. At the same time, this even memory bank is also called as the lower bank. And the odd memory bank will be called as the higher bank. If we see the locations of the even memory as well as the odd memory, when we look at these two addresses, see, zero comes first, later one comes, right? So when we compare these two, zero will be the lower number and one will be the higher number, right? So in this sense, if we compare any two locations, right, that we can easily observe that this particular even memory bank is containing the lower numbers and the odd number memory bank is containing the higher numbers. So this way, whatever the even memory bank that is there, we call that one as lower bank. And the addresses that are contained in case of the odd memory bank will be also called as the higher memory bank. Now, this is the particular diagram which can easily tells us how we are going to access and how the data can be accessed through the even address bank as well as the odd address bank. Now we will be having the 8086 microprocessor system, and that is provided with the address lines as well as the data lines. So here it is having the 16 data lines. So those 16 data lines will be D0 to D15, right? So here, in order to access the lower byte, D0 to D7 data lines that we are using, and in order to access the contents in the odd address bank, and we are using the data lines D8 to D15. So D8 to D15 will be used to carry the higher byte, and D0 to D7 bus is used to transfer the lower byte. Now, if we want to transfer the 16-bit data, then how we can transfer, right? Is there anything behind selecting only the even address bank or odd address bank, or at a time I just wanted to use those two address banks, including even as well as the odd? So this can be accessible depending on two pins. So one pin is A0 and another pin is BHE bar. So this BHE bar stands for the bus high enabled. So the combination of BHE bar and A0 gives the information that which bank is active and is there any chance to make those two banks are active, or we can do we get any chance not to access those two memory banks? Everything that we can cover by looking at the combinations of the ones and zeros for the BHE bar and A0 bar. Now if we look at the first combination, when BHE bar and A0 both are logic zero, then both the banks will be active, so that the 16-bit data can be transferred on the multiplexed data lines, right? So we know there will be the multiplexed data lines and address lines as from AD0 to AD15. So when this particular BHE bar and A0 combination is 00, then both the banks will be active and we can transfer the lower byte as well as the higher byte data. In the same way, if BHE bar is 0 and A0 is 1, then only higher bank, that is odd bank, will be active and one byte of data transfer will be done on the higher order data lines, that is AD8 to AD15. Okay, so here we can see that higher byte can be transferred to D8 to D15. So this is the data line. So basically, if you look at that, will be multiplexed with the address line also. And if the combination is like this, if BHE bar is 1 and A0 is 0, then only lower bank, that is even bank, will be active. At that time also, only 1 byte of data can be transferred from the lower order data bus, that is from D0 to D7. And if the combination is 1-1, so A0 is 1 as well as BHE bar is also 1, then no memory bank will be active and we don't see that any transfer of data on the data line to the banks or from the banks. So this A0 as well as the BHE bar combinations tells that when that even bank is active, when the odd bank is active, and when both the banks are active, and how the data transfer is keep going on. This is also the simplified diagram for what we have seen in the previous slide. So we will be having the odd memory bank and we will be having the even memory bank. Now, let us consider the addresses are like this, 10,000, 10,002, 10,004. If you look at these addresses, everything will be on even number. So the even bank will be containing the even addresses. And here, if you look at the memory locations, they will be your containing the odd numbered location. So it will be the odd bank. As we know that this odd bank will be having the higher order address bank, higher order addresses, and even bank will be having the lower order addresses. So based on the combinations of BHE as well as the A0, that particular bank or the banks will be active, and correspondingly the data will be transferred. So here we will be having the D0 to D15 data bus as well as the address bus A0 to A19. So this address bus is connected to the odd bank as well as the even bank. At that particular address, based on the BHE bar and A0 combinations, that particular data bus will be connected to the particular corresponding bank. So here, if we have a 16-bit data, like 1, 2, 3, 4H, let us consider. So this 3, 4 is the lower byte. This will be the lower byte. And this 1, 2 will be the upper byte. Right? So when BHE bar as well as A0 are given as 0, 0, then this 3, 4 will go to this particular location and this 1, 2 go to this particular location. So like this, whenever we transferred the 16-bit data, depending on the BHE bar and A0 conditions, right? So the lower data goes to the lower address, that is it goes to the even bank, and the higher order data will go to the odd bank. The lower byte data will be transferred through the D0 to D7, and the higher order data will be transferred through the D8 to D15, higher order data bus. So this way, there are various ways to transfer or access the data from the memory, right? So there we can see as four different ways. So that one we can say that 8-bit data from even address bank, so we can access a 8-bit data or 1-byte data from even address bank, or we can also access the 1-byte data from the odd address bank, or 16-bit data starting from even address bank. We can directly see that we can access that 16-bit data starting from even address bank, or also we can access the 16-bit data starting from the odd address bank. So based on the location which were filled previously, so next location will be taken into account, and based on that, we can also access the 16-bit data, which is starting from the odd address bank. So these are the four different ways how we can access the data from the memory. So this is all about the physical memory organization of microprocessor 8086. Hope you understood the concept of physical memory organization. Like, comment, share, and subscribe my channel for more technical content. Thanks for watching.